Racing to the 2023 Kentucky Derby, and this time we go to Tampa Bay for the Sam F. Davis. Yes, Tampa Bay Downs Saturday. It's part of a big card that includes the Suncoast Stakes, and of course it sets it all up for the Tampa Bay Derby and the festival day at Tampa Bay Downs on March 11th. We will take a look at this field. Don't forget, we've got previews up this week of the Suncoast Stakes, and also already up on the channel is a Kentucky Derby update from last Sunday. Meanwhile, they are going to go on Saturday at Tampa Bay Downs, and they are going to go a mile and a 16th. Let's take a look at this field. Of course, Tampa Bay Derby comes up on March 11th, starting off with the rail horse Worthington. Wins at Keeneland and Churchill Downs, goes turf to dirt for Mike Maker, trying to pick up some Kentucky Derby points, 20 points to the winner of this race. Prairie Hawk, looking for the hat trick for Safi Joseph, was won back-to-back races. Nice bullet workout this week. Prairie Hawk should be speed on the inside. Classic Legacy ships in for Bill Mott. He's had a couple of big Saturdays in a row, winning with Art Collector, winning the Holy Bull Stakes. Now he tries to make it the triple by winning the Sam F. Davis Classic Legacy, improving first race at Tampa, and beat a small field the last time, but did it striding out in the lane. Laver ships in for George Arnold. He's got some class. I like the fact that he's got some distance races already on the resume. Meanwhile, Groveland is one of the local hopefuls. Groveland, a horse for course, moving a little bit up in class, facing a full field here in the Sam F. Davis. Classic Car Wash, back-to-back wins for Mark Cassie. He's going to add some speed along with Prairie Hawk and Zydeco in this race. Classic Car Wash scratched out of the allowance race last week at Gulfstream Park for the Sam F. Davis. WHNL picked up a win in the Remsen Stakes, also picked up a maiden win in the Slop in New York. Comes off a layoff, been working steadily for the last month, trying to pick up some Kentucky Derby points. He's already got 10 points on the trail, and he'll probably be one of the top three favorites in the race. Nota has a win at Tampa. Champion's Dream tried to close the last time, lost to Zydeco. In the Pasco Stakes, he did win the Nashua Stakes. Champion's Dream, the second horse for Mark Cassie. Dreaming of Kona ships in from Gulfstream, picked up a win the last time via the DQ. Litigate faced a key race the last time at Gulfstream Park, ships in for Todd Pletcher. He does well at Tampa Bay Downs in these stakes races. And then Zydeco won the Pasco Stakes the last time as an upset. Speed on the outside. There does seem to be some speed in this race. You've got the turf to dirt horse in Worthington, Prairie Hawk is in good form, Dubyuhnell off a layoff, and then Classic Legacy. You can't overlook Bill Mott at this time of the year. It's nice to have him on the trail with some several different contenders, and Classic Legacy does have a nice pedigree on him. WHYNL gonna try to pick up where he left off after winning that Remsen Stakes. That speed figure came back fast, and he did beat Arctic Arrogance, who came back with another second place finish. Now the top contenders, WHNL, Prairie Hawk for Safi Joseph, Litigate for Todd Pletcher, Champion's Dream, I think with that Nashua form, closing last time at Tampa, he's already got a trip over the track. That's one thing you notice over the years, a lot of times a horse that has a trip over the track does seem to do well. It always seems like there's always a horse or two that just kind of spins their wheel, especially coming in from Gulfstream Park. Weather's supposed to be in the upper 60s, lower 70s at Tampa Bay on Saturday. Classic Legacy, another one, a chance to get over the surface after running at that deep aqueduct service last time out. Litigate goes for Todd Pletcher. Let's take a look at his most recent race. Of course, he lost to Cyclone Mischief. That was off a layoff, but he was wider out than Cyclone Mischief. Made a mid-race move in that race. Second start off the form cycle, and Litigate, definitely one of the top contenders here in the Sam F. Davis, going for Todd Pletcher. Prairie Hawk, wire to wire at Tampa, sharp furlong work. Let's look at his last race. Went wire to wire, picked up the lead, then was able to kind of dig in the stretch. That was a small field. Faces a much larger field and some other speed in this race, but Prairie Hawk definitely on the improve, and I like the recent workouts. WHNL, Remsen winner, a maiden win in the slop. We're going to go back to his maiden race. Look at him gobble up ground here in the final strides. Looked like he was kind of beat at the eighth pole. Ended up digging in, won that race, came back and won the Remsen Stakes after that. Wins on the lead. He did come off the pace in this maiden win and, of course, a chance to maybe improve here at Tampa Bay, but he does have a little bit of a layoff. Now, early pace, I see Prairie Hawk, Zydeco, and Classic Car Wash. I think those three could all vie for the lead, with probably Prairie Hawk with that good post position most likely to be on the lead at the half-mile pole. Now, the presser, WHNL, along with Classic Legacy, I think they can come just off the pace. They may not have the raw speed to hang up with Prairie Hawk or Zydeco. And then the closers, Litigate, I think he's going to come from off the pace, especially with that post position. My top selection in the Sam F. Davis is going to be Litigate. I like the way he made that mid-race move the last time. I liked his win in New York. Stretches out here, and I'm going to play him in exactas over Prairie Hawk, Champions Dream, and WHNL. Again, Saturday at Tampa Bay Downs. Who do you like in the Sam F. Davis? We're going to have previews up of the Suncoast Stakes. Going to be doing some live reports on Saturday from Tampa Bay Downs, and then also a Friday night Tampa Bay Downs handicapping show where we go all through all the races, set you up for the pick fours and pick fives on Saturday at Tampa Bay Downs. It's all part of the festival preview day. Sam F. Davis, who do you like? And the trail continues. We've got the Risen Star, the Rebel, the Fountain of Youth, the Gotham, and the San Felipe as we start seeing stakes races every week here as we get you ready for the 2023 Kentucky Derby.